Tonight, my dear Maxwell, I'm ready to try my experiment on a human.
Yes?
In the morgue, there is a lethal gas suicide.
An ideal specimen.
Have you made arrangements?
No. You know I do not work under prying eyes. You will find a way for me to work without detection. It is your chance to show me your gratitude for my generosity and protection.
I will never forget what you have done for me, and will do anything to help you. But the morgue, dead people. Suppose we should be caught.
How many times have you told me of your impersonations? That you never had a chance? Maybe your art will serve you after all. You have seen the coroner? Why not impersonate him?
No.
That's it! No. Impersonate him! The time has come when you can repay me for what I have done.
It's horrible, I tell you. Working on the dead. Trying to bring back life. It's not natural.
You with your weird idea.
Haven't I stayed here and nursed dying dogs?
Yeah.
And even that miserable cat? And for what? For a measly roof and food. Because you took me in.
And I was down and out.
Once a ham, always a ham. You, an actor? But don't forget, my dear Maxwell, the police would be very glad to find you.
I didn't mean I wouldn't.
Of course not. In time, you may become a great man.
Not only do I look like Meyer Schultz, I am Meyer Schultz. I will be a great man. I'll give him a shot to relieve the nerve tension. dream.
They drove me to it, I tell you. They drove me with hunger, with misery and humiliation. I only wanted to amuse, to entertain. But here I am. Spent my life in perfecting an art that no one wanted. No one appreciated.
I showed them Dr. Marshall.
A real impersonation.
My assault. My supreme impersonation. This is the one. Here.
File number 26941. Maria Altura, 24, suicide. Carbon monoxide gas, not claimed.
This is getting heavier and more of them every day.
Between the gangsters and the auto divers, we don't need another war to carry off the population.
You didn't even mention suicides. They even got the coroner working overtime. Say, did you see the beaut that come in today?
Did I?
She's the one that has the coroner doing the night work.
What? Special autopsy?
Must be. I wonder who that old Santa Claus is.
I must get her out of here. She must have oxygen. Huh. Unlock the side door and back up the cart. But watch out for the guard. And as soon as he's out of the way, we'll take her out of here.
You say the corpse of the young woman has been stolen.
Yes. And it sure has me puzzled. Why, Mike thought I took it.
I'd have swore it was the coroner himself.
There must have been a very strong resemblance.
Yeah, he was a dead image of him. And talked like him, too.
Oh, you talked to him?
No. No, he was talking to some other old fellow there that looked like Santa Claus, as I said to Jake. He had whiskers and bushy hair, and his eyes was wild, and it must have been some other two fellas.
Could you positively identify if you saw the party?
I wouldn't swear to anything now after being so sure to the coroner.
You know, Mike's description is very much like your friend Meyer Schultz. Tell me, have you seen him of late?
Well, why, Dr. Meyer Schultz is really a great research scientist. Why, he has formulated some amazing methods for preserving gland extracts in the most potent state. He's no body snatcher.
Well, doctors and scientists often have some queer things in their mind. Anyway, I'll look into it.
Go easy, Jones. I wouldn't like to offend the doctor.
Don't worry. I'll do nothing to embarrass you.
Thank you.
Captain, what'll I do about this?
Collins, see if you have anything there on Don Maxwell. Last heard from in this city. Impersonations, vaudeville. Yeah. Okay, Cap.
Let's see what they got in their files on Don Maxwell. Do you know Dr. Meyer Schultz and his assistant, Don Maxwell?
Sure. They're sort of queer, I'd say. There's lots of queer goings on up there. Why, they even brought a dead dog back to life once.
Well, that sounds very remarkable to me.
It may be, but to my notion, those that monkeys with what they got no business to gets queer sooner or later.
Maybe you're right.
I know I am. Why, I even heard a shot up there last night.
Why didn't you notify the police?
That's their business, not mine.
I understand from your neighbors that your cats are making noise at night. Dr. Meyer Schultz has complained.
Yeah, but he's been stealing my cats for his experiments. I know. I've been spying on him.
How many cats have you? What's the matter, rats?
Oh, thousands of them. Right here in my backyard.
Thousands?
Yeah, I got 1,000 cats, too. Want to see them?
What's the idea? You sell them?
No. It's my own idea. I'm in the business. Fur business.
Oh, I see cat's fur.
You'll get it quick.
Where do the rats come in?
You ain't as quick as I thought. Look. You see, I figured out that rats breed faster than cats. And cat skins makes good fur. Cats eat rats. And rats eat raw meat. That is, they eat the carcasses of the cat. So, the rats eat the cat. The cats eat the rats. And I get the skins.
Well, rats eating cats? Well, that is news.
Simple, ain't it?
Say, by the way, did you hear a shot last night?
Maybe. I don't know.
All right, Mrs. Buckley. We will go downstairs now. I have a special treatment room there. There now. You will feel better.
Let me.
Doctor, he seems to be getting worse instead of better.
Stealing through my body. Creeping through my veins. Pouring in my blood. Darts of fire in my brain. Stabbing me. Agony. I can't stand this torture, this torment. I can't stand it. I won't. I won't. I won't.
What was in that hypo?
Oh.